بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Welcome dear brothers and sisters to this lecture in the course وصول الأحكام. We will continue inshallah with the chapter of fasting and then we will go also through a quick review of the chapter of fasting inshallah, so that if we missed anything from the hadith or any judgment from the hadith inshallah, we will recap it inshallah. So we stopped at the hadith number 196, in which Aisha radiallahu anha narrated that قالت كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يكون علي الصوم من رمضان فما أستطيع أن أقضي إلا في شعبان. So Aisha radiallahu anha says that she missed some of the days in Ramadan, of course, because of the period, and then she couldn't, as a lifetime of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she couldn't fast in other days except in the next Shaaban, and just before the next Ramadan, or just before the following Ramadan. So why she couldn't make up the missed days in Ramadan just once Ramadan finished? Because she was very busy with the matters of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So she said that I missed days in Ramadan and I couldn't. She didn't say I didn't. She said I couldn't make up these days unless or except after in Sha'ban, in the next Sha'ban. Aisha radiallahu anha reported also that she was fasting all the year, but this is after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. So imagine the difference in the life of Aisha radiallahu anha. Imagine how she was busy with the matters of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was alive, she couldn't make up the missed days in Ramadan, the fard, the wajib, except in next Sha'ban, just before Ramadan. After the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, she observed fasting the whole year. Of course, except the prohibited days, but she observed the fasting of the whole year, radiallahu anha. Hadith number 197, عن عائشة radiallahu anha, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من مات وعليه صيام صام عنه وليه. So these hadiths are in the making up of the missed days in Ramadan. So from the first hadith we can conclude that it is not an immediate obligation after Ramadan to make up the missed days in Ramadan. Aisha radiallahu anha just made up or fast the missed days just in Sha'ban, yani after 10 months, right? 10 months. So from this hadith we can conclude that it is not an immediate obligation. So it is not an obligation to fast in Shawwal, the missed days in Ramadan. Okay? So, but still, you are required to fast it. So the question is, if someone missed some days in Ramadan and he died before he make up these days, then this is the next narration. Aisha radiallahu anha also reported that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من مات وعليه صيام صام عنه وليه. Whoever die while he has on his burden to fast some missed days in Ramadan, then his wali will fast for him. And the wali here may be his father or mother or his daughter or son, or his brother and sisters, those who are around him.
Can we share this, like mother to
mother? Yes, they can. Yes, you can.
To me, it's an obligation also to inform our family the number of days.
Yes, sure, sure, sure. In case Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just, in case the person die, then his family know how much days they can fast for him, inshallah. Yes.
For mothers who do not fast because they're breastfeeding.
Because?
They're breastfeeding.
Who will teach us, inshallah? Abu Dawood, radiallahu anhu, said, "This is exclusively this narration is exclusively in the Nadhr." And this narration of the one who died and his wali will fast for him, this is exclusively in Nadhr. But the majority of scholars say it is also in the fasting of Ramadan. Hadith number 198 عن عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا رسول الله إن أمي ماتت وعليها صوم شهر أفأقضيه عنها قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لو كان على أمك دين أكنت قاضيه عنها قال نعم قال فدين الله أحق أن يقضى وفي رواية جاءت امرأة إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقالت يا رسول الله إن أمي ماتت وعليها صوم نذر أفأصوم عنها قال أفرأيتي لو كان على أمك دين فقضيتيه أكان يؤدي ذلك عنها قالت نعم قال فصومي عن أمك. So this narration, Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه narrated that a man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and asked him, O Messenger of Allah, my mother died while she has the burden of fasting for 1 month. This narration didn't say it is the month of Ramadan or it is a nadhr fasting. This narration didn't say this. Just he said that my mother have to fast for 1 month, but she died before she fast. Then the man asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, shall I make up instead of my mother? Make up these days, this month, to fast this month instead of my mother. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if your mother has a doubt, has a debt, would you like pay the debt for her? The man answered, yes. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, then the debt of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is worthy to be paid. That means this month is like a debt in his neck, on her burden. So the debt of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is worthy to be paid. The same narration, in another narration, a woman came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is the second narration. A woman came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and asked him the same question with slightly differentiation. She said that, O Messenger of Allah, my mother died while she has a fasting of nazar. So this woman was specific. She said, the fasting of my mother was not Ramadan, it was a nadhr. Then she asked the same question, shall I fast for my mother instead of my mother? The Prophet ﷺ answered the same question, if your mother has a debt, then would you pay for it? She said, yes. And then the Prophet ﷺ said, then fast for your mother. So these two narrations, the man asked for 1 month, and the woman asked for a nadhr. And in both narrations, as long as the fasting is obligation, is a burden on the person and he dies, then his wali or his father, mother, sister, brother, son, daughter, so, etc., they have to fast for the deceased person. Yes, sister? It is not a kind of inheritance. is a kind of, it is the same as the Prophet said, it is the same of a debt. Like this is the debt of the people and this is the debt of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She has, even the kafara, it is the same. When someone die before giving the kafara for the nadhr or for the swear or ayman or for the halif or even for the fasting, then his wali or his family, surrounding family, shall share the responsibility to pay for him because it's a debt of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is not a kind of inheritance, it is a kind of obligation, a kind of obligation, fulfilling his obligations.
What about if it was a punishment, the ask for a punishment, like the one who had relations during Ramadan?
Yes, yes. Kafara. They have to give the kafara from his money. So if he die, and they have to give the kafara from his money before they share the inheritance.
So it's not related to fasting for that person also, for example, that person has to fast them 2 months.
No. They have to distribute the kafara.
Like yeah.
No.
Cannot
split.
No. That person has to fast 60
days. No person has to fast these 60 days. They have to give the kafara from his money, from his inheritance.
No need to fast.
No.
Just go straight to the third one.
Yeah.
The third one.
Go the third. Yes, yes, it happened. Yeah, yeah. Then it is not obligation for them, but it is recommended. Yeah. It will be recommended, inshallah.
Oh, so if the deceased doesn't have any money, then there is no obligation for the wali to use their own money to settle the
kafara. Again, please.
If the deceased doesn't have any money left. So if he has outstanding kafara,
yes.
Wali do not have to use their own money to settle.
It is not obligated because this is not like it's not their kafara. It's a kafara of another person. Even if he is their father, their mother, or something like this, but it's a kafara of another person, not their own kafara. So they have to distribute the kafara from his own money. If they didn't have, then they will not be obligated, but recommended.
So the wali is recommended, like if he has the money, then
yeah, if he has the money,
like
of course,
pay the debt for this person.
Of course. And it's, imagine the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The answer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that if your mother has a debt, would you pay for it? This is the question. Yani, if the one has the ability to pay for his father's debts or for his father's obligations, then he have to do so. Hadith number 199 عن سهل بن سعد الساعدي رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا يزال الناس بخير ما عجلوا الفطرة وأخروا السحور. So this is another topic related to the etiquettes of Ramadan, in the fasting of Ramadan, and even in the fasting of month other than Ramadan or days other than in Ramadan. So this is for sunnah or obligatory fasting. لا يزال الناس بخير ما عجلوا الفطرة وأخروا السحور. People are still in good as long as they hasten to breaking their fast directly after Maghrib and delaying eating their suhoor. So some people just remain until the end of Adhan, for example, and then they begin to eat or drink. Just once you hear Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, you can eat, no problem, inshallah. Hadith number 200 عن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أقبل الليل منها هنا وأدبر النهار منها هنا وغربت الشمس فقد أفطر الصائم. And this also indicates when to break the fasting or when to eat and drink at Maghrib or before Fajr. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه related to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that he said, of course, the Prophet was like indicating by his hands, like إذا أقبل الليل منها هنا, if the night comes from this direction, and أدبر النهار منها هنا, and the daylight just went to this direction. This means the process of sunset. And then he said, and the sunset at this time, the person who observes fasting may break his fasting. So the Prophet ﷺ defined the time in which the Muslim or the person who observes fasting may break his fasting just after the sunset. It means exactly the time of Maghrib. Because the time of Maghrib starts just exactly after sunset. حديث نمبر 201 عن عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال نهى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الوصال قالوا يا رسول الله إنك تواصل قال إني لست كهيئتكم إني أطعم وأسقى ورواه أبو هريرة وعائشة وأنس بن مالك. So the issue of الوصال means the person chose to not to eat at Maghrib, just to eat one meal a day. Like he chose to not to eat at Maghrib, just continue the fasting until Fajr.
This is called Al-Wisal.
So this is called Al-Wisal, yes. So Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu said the Prophet prohibited the wisal. So we are forbidden to make al-wisal or to continue fasting up until the Fajr time. The Sahaba said, "Ya Messenger, O Messenger of Allah, you observe wisal." The Prophet himself was doing the wisal. So the Prophet ﷺ said, I am not like you. Or, إني لست كهيئتكم means I am not in the same status as you. Because I am being like fed and drink. Like the Prophet ﷺ or the status of the Prophet ﷺ is different from the status of the Sahaba, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is used to be like a Nabi or a Prophet or a Messenger, in which he may observe some things which is very hard for other people, and this is maybe exclusive for the Prophets or Messengers. They can observe some of the worship, some of the acts of worship, which is very hard to be endured by other people. So that he said, I'm not like you. I have more capabilities, I have more characteristics that enables me to do the wisal or enables me to observe the wisal, but you are not. So here, the Prophet ﷺ prohibited the Sahaba from observing the wisal or from doing the wisal, which is to continue the fasting up until Fajr. In another narration for the same topic, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu continued, فَأَيُّكُمْ أَرَادَ أَن يُوَاصِلْ فَلْيُوَاصِلْ إِلَى السَّحَرِ. So if any one of you wanted to do a wasal or wanted to observe the wasal, it should be up until the time before Fajr, not the time of Fajr. The Sahar means the time of that's before Fajr or the time of Sahur. So this is the narration of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu. But in any case, in another narrations, the Sahaba insisted to do the wisal. So that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam observed with them the wisal for 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, and after the 3 days, they felt that they finished. Then the Sahaba said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we will not do the wisal. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what we have the narration here is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam naha an al-wisal, didn't allow the Sahaba to do the wisal or to observe the wisal. So it is from the Sunnah, from the obligations, to break your fast at maghrib time, or as soon as you can. Yes. So this is the statement of Abu Sa'id radiallahu anhu. That means Abu Sa'id radiallahu anhu said, if someone want to do the wisal, it should be until the time before Fajr, because the wisal in their understanding is that you continue the fasting. So to break this kind of meaning or this meaning in their understanding, Abu Sa'id said, if you want to continue fasting, observe the fast, it should be up until the time that is before Fajr of the next day, the time of Sahar. Because if they will observe the wisal, they will not eat at the time of the Sahar.
It's continuous.
Yeah, it's continuous. Just before Fajr, they may eat something which is light food like this, and then they could continue for the next day. Of course, this is very tough for the people, yeah.
So is this makruh or is it prohibited?
If we say naha Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that means it's for prohibition. Unless we have some of the other narrations that may say it's allowed and it's not mansukh. And in any case, this kind of wisal is prohibited, yeah. It's prohibited.
So the second one is the saying of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri.
Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu.
The third one, the 3 days, is just the Sahaba's practice.
No, this is not in the book. Yes, this is not in the book.
Is that in the context of
Wisal,
it's a is this considered ibadah, or is it just so happen that for some people they just eat one day and then they forgot, or maybe.
No, it was like a kind I don't like to say it is extremism in ibadah, but it is not like their normal habit to just eat one meal a day. No, it was like just to increase their hungry and to increase their state of sawm and to be in the state of some for as long as they can and so on and forth. So it has some of the indications of ibadah, not their normal habit. Yeah.
Ustaz, in terms of fiqh, we should harmonize the hadith that we cannot do wisal, right? Although there is a recommendation of when we can do wisal, but we cannot do wisal.
Yes, we cannot do wisal.
Yeah.
Even if we can do wisal, what's better is the comment of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What's better for us is the Sunnah, not what we can do. Because, for example, you know the hadith of the three persons who came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of them said, "I will not marry." The other said, "I will stand the whole night," and the other said, "I will fast for the whole year." So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "This is not ibadah. This is not a kind of ibadah," and he said, the sunnah is the ibadah, and the sunnah is to marry and to sleep and to not to observe fasting for every day. So this is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is worthy to be followed.
Because I've heard also some people they do diet, and so they have like one meal.
Of course, diet is different from the wisal.
No. Because like for some people they have the one meal a day.
Yes. If this is their habit, it's okay. But at least, you just eat something which is very light. You just eat dates at time of Maghrib, drink water, drink juice, and that's it. This is how you break your fasting. But to observe fasting for the purpose of fasting, then this is the wrong thing.
The definition of wisal.
Yes. Yes, just before Fajr. And they even they eat very light things, yani not to have a meal for the whole sahur. They just try to try to punish yani themselves. That's why the Sahaba didn't endure this dawsal for the third day or for more than 3 days. Yeah. So hadith number 203, chapter of what is the best fasting, under the categorization of what is the best fasting, and in this category we will have narration about Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu. And Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu was one of the Sahaba who was doing as much as he can in observing the worship. And this hadith will show you this. عن عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنه قال أخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أني أقول والله لا أصومن النهار ولا أقومن الليلة ما عشت. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنت الذي قلت ذلك؟ فقلت له قد قلته بأبي أنت وأمي يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال فإنك لا تستطيع ذلك، فصم وأفطر وقم ونم، وصم من الشهر 3 أيام، فإن الحسنة بعشر أمثالها، وذلك مثل صيام الدهر. قلت إني لا أطيق أفضل من ذلك. قال فصم يوما وأفطر يومين. قال إني لا أطيق أفضل من ذلك. قال فصم يوما وأفطر يوما، فذلك صيام داود عليه السلام وهو أفضل الصيام. قلت إني لا أطيق أفضل من ذلك. فقال لا أفضل من ذلك، لا أفضل من ذلك. وفي رواية قال لا صوم فوق صوم أخي داود عليه السلام شطر الدهر، صم يوما وأفطر يوما. So before we translate the narration of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu, the chapter is entitled what is the best fasting, or what is the best types of fasting. Of course, there are some narrations in which the Prophet ﷺ this is the best fasting, but in terms of, because the context of the narration is in the sunnah fasting, not the fard fasting. So what is the best fasting? It should be like, or it should be explained as after the fasting of Ramadan. Because the best fasting is the fasting of the month of Ramadan, which is the rukn of Islam. The pillar of Islam is the best fasting, which is the fasting of the month of Ramadan. After the obligatory fasting, or after the fasting of the month of Ramadan, then we can consider this narration about Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu. So Abdullah ibn Amr al-As radiallahu anhu told that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told that Abdullah ibn Amr al-As, that I say, by Allah, I will fast all days and stand in night prayer for all the night. So as much as I live, so until the end of my life, I will fast all days and stand in prayer in all nights, in the whole night. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam met him and asked him, did you say what I heard, that you say I will fast and I will pray? Abdullah ibn Amr al-As answered, yes, I said, ya Rasulullah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the wise answer again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you cannot. Simple question, a simple answer. You cannot. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You cannot fast and break your fast. So don't fast all days, fast some days, and don't fast other days. And stand in night prayer and sleep. Within the night, stand in night prayer, pray for the night prayer, Qiyam al-Layl, and sleep. And fast for every month, 3 days. So he said that you cannot. The Prophet ﷺ was told that he will fast for whole days, for all days. He will stand for the whole night, every night. So the Prophet ﷺ said clearly to one of the companions who was like a young man at this time, Abdullah ibn Abd al-As and Abdullah ibn Abbas were young people at this time. So he was young and he was strong. But the Prophet ﷺ said, you cannot. You cannot observe this throughout your life. So fast some days and don't fast other days. Pray at certain part of night and sleep at the other part. And fast only every month for 3 days. Every month. Not 30 days, 3 days. Because the hasana or the good deed is doubled in 10. So the Abdullah ibn al-As said, I will fast 30 days, right? The month is 30 days. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, fast 3 days and each one is doubled by 10. So imagine how the mercy of the Prophet ﷺ to his ummah, to his nation. Then Abdullah ibn Amr al-As said, I can do more. So the Prophet ﷺ said to him, fast three days a month. Abdullah ibn Amr al-As, a young man, said, I can do more. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, then fast for 1 day and break your fast for 2 days. So for every 3 days, you will fast 1 day. Okay? Abdullah ibn Amr al-As said, radiallahu anhu, I can do more. So the Prophet ﷺ said, then fast for 1 day and break your fast for the other day. So fast day by day. Then Abdullah ibn Amr al-As said, what he said? I can do more. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just I will continue the narration. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, fast for 1 day and break your fast for the other day. This is the fasting of Dawood alayhi salam, the Prophet Dawood alayhi salam. And this is the best fasting. And this is the best types of fasting. Then when Abdullah ibn Amr al-As replied, I can do more, the Prophet ﷺ said, there is nothing better than this. Khalas, finish. There is nothing better than this. And in another narration, the Prophet ﷺ said for the same Sahabi, there is no fasting over the fasting of my brother Dawood alayhi salam. Shatr al-Dahri, half of the year. So he was fasting for 1 day, or breather fasting for the other day, half of the year. So yawman wa after yawman. Then fast a day by day. So this is the advice of the Prophet ﷺ to one of the young companions, Abdullah ibn al-As radiallahu anhu. In another narration, which is not in the book, Abdullah ibn al-As, once he get elder, he said, I hope I listen to the Prophet ﷺ. So imagine. Because, why this? Because Abdullah ibn Amr al-As radiallahu anhu hates to change something upon which he left the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was not an obligation upon Abdullah ibn Amr al-As to fast day by day, but he hates to change what he used to do with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised him then fast day by day, he observed fasting day by day, and he hates to change this advice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Once he get elder, he said that, I hope I listen to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In another narration with the same topic, hadith number 204, عن عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أحب الصيام إلى الله صيام داود عليه السلام وأحب الصلاة إلى الله صلاة داود عليه السلام. كان ينام نصف الليل ويقوم ثلثه وينام سدسه وكان يصوم يوما ويفطر يوما. So Abdullah ibn Amr al-Nas, the same Sahabi, reported that the Prophet ﷺ said, the most beloved types of fasting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the fasting of Dawood alayhi salam. And the most beloved pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was the prayer of Dawood alayhi salam. The most beloved prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the prayer of Dawood alayhi salam. How was the prayer of Dawood alayhi salam in the night prayer or Qiyamul Layl of Dawood alayhi salam? This is also after the obligatory prayer, because the obligatory prayer is beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than any kind of sunnah prayer. The same for fasting. The obligatory fasting is more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than any kind of sunnah fasting. And this is the explanation of what the Prophet said in the Hadith Qudsi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا تَقَرَّبَ عَبْدِي إِلَيَّ بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّ افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ. My servant will not get closer to me with any kind of worship or with anything of worship more than what I commanded him as obligation. It means the fard, the salah, the sawm, the zakah, the hajj. This is the most beloved acts of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But in these hadiths, as I mentioned before, in these narrations, to explain what is the best after the obligations, or what is the best after the pillars of Islam. So, regarding the Qiyamul Layl of Dawood alayhi salam, was the most beloved types of Qiyamul Layl to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How was the Qiyamul Layl of Dawood alayhi salam? He was asleep for midnight. Until midnight. He used to sleep until midnight, Dawood alayhi salam. Then he used to stand in prayer, used Qiyam al-Layl, for one third, and then to sleep again for one sixth. So if you just divide the whole night, it will be like two halves. The first half, sleeping. The second half, one third is standing in prayer, and the rest for one sixth is sleeping again. وَكَانَ يَصُومُ يَوْمًا وَيُفْتُرُ يَوْمًا. And he used to fast a day by day. So this is the most beloved sunnah acts regarding the prayer or regarding the fasting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No. Yes. So this is the night from 6 p.m. for example to 6 a.m. right? So here until 12 a.m. sleeping. This is one. This is a half of midnight, he was sleeping. Until one third meal, 1, 2, 3, 4. Until 4 a.m. prayer. Then until 6 again, sleeping. So this is how the prayer or the night prayer of Dawood alayhi salam. Hadith number 205. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال أوصاني خليلي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بثلاث صيام ثلاثة أيام من كل شهر وركعتي الضحى وأن أوتر قبل أن أنام. Then also this is one of the types of sunnah, of the fasting of sunnah fasting, not the Ramadan fasting. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrated that أوصاني خليلي صلى الله رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. My Khalil, Khalil in the Arabic means the, not the friend, the close friend. The close friend, the very close friend. So Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said, my close friend, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, advised me with three things. The first one is to fast for 3 days every month. So every month we fast for 3 days. It is sunnah, it is general sunnah to fast any 3 days of the month. From the first, from the beginning, from the middle, or at the end. But it is more recommended to be like 13, 14, and 15, the middle days.
Sorry,
yes? Yes?
You said just now you can do any time of the month.
Yes.
The recommended, I'm aware of 13, 14.
This is recommended and this is more recommended. Like it's recommended to fast for any 3 days. The Prophet ﷺ himself, in other narrations, said just fast for 3 days, and he himself fasted for days which are not 13, 14, or and 15. So the Prophet ﷺ also observed fasting in 3 days, other than the middle 3 days. But there are other narrations which specifies the 13 and 14 and 15, the middle 3 days. So we say, in general, it's recommended to fast for 3 days, and it's more recommended to fast on the middle days. Yes? It is not a must to be in sequence. You can fast in any 3 days separately. This is another kind of sunnah also. This is the sunnah of Prophet ﷺ himself, to fast for Mondays and Thursdays. Yes.
When he said 3 days, does that refer to the 13, 14, 15 or any?
No, this is the same as here. The Prophet ﷺ advised him to fast for 3 days, and he said this is the fasting of the whole year. Why? Because for 3 days it will be multiple for 30 days. And then for 30 days, that means for every month you fast 30 days, that means you fast the whole year. So this is the same narration, the same advice from the Prophet ﷺ to another companion, in which he said he advised him to fast for 3 days every month. The second advice is to observe Ad-Duha. 2 rak'ahs, rak'atay al-duha, and to pray the rak'ahs of al-duha, 2 rak'ahs of al-duha. And the third advice is to an utira qabla an anam, to pray witr before I sleep. Before I go to sleep, I pray the witr rak'ah. Yes.
So, is the ajr the same as the recommended, or?
For the ajr, we cannot say these are more than this, or because it's all sunnah. We don't know what is the ajr, but it is a sunnah. It is from observing the sunnah. And if you can do the best, which is the more recommended, you can do. Otherwise, it will also be a kind of sunnah to observe any 3 days, inshallah.
You mentioned
2 rak'ah, so it's specifically 2 rak'ah. Yes.
And then the witr, is it like any number of
1
or 3 or
5?
Or
no, he said an utira qabla an, to pray witr. So to pray witr by 1 rak'ah, by 3 rak'ahs, by 5 rak'ahs, no, it's not mentioned. Yeah, the advice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the advice, the kind of advice. The advice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu is to pray before go to sleep, to pray witr before go to sleep. Some people are certain, have certainty to pray, to wake up before Fajr, then it is recommended to delay witr to this time, because this time is more blessed than the beginning of night. So if you are certain, it's okay, you can delay it. If you are not certain, then make sure to pray before you go to sleep.
Ustaz, if we pray a week before we sleep, then we wake up before
good, good question. Good question. If someone prays a witr before he sleep, then he wake up before Fajr, like half an hour before Fajr, and this is the most blessed time in the day and night. Then he is allowed to pray, but not to repeat the witr again. To pray 2 units by 2 units until the Fajr, until the Adhan of the Fajr. Why? Because he already prayed the witr, and the Prophet just teaches us that the witr is one time only. He never taught us that you can do witr for 2 times for 1 night. He said that witr for 1 time only. So you can observe fast, doing 2 units by 2 units until the Adhan of the Fajr, even if you pray the witr before you go to sleep. Yes?
Khalil.
Khalil means the close friend.
Who said my Khalil?
This is Abu Huraira
radiallahu anhu. So, Abu Huraira's Khalil is Prophet?
Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu described the Prophet as his close friend. So he said, my close friend, the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just advised me with 3 advices. Okay, clear?
Okay, it's not specific for you, sir. Just the duha for 2 rakat is not specific, meaning from the time that I can pray in that period. I
mean, in this narration, no. But in another narration, the duha is after the sunrise. Let's say in our modern time, after sunrise by 20 minutes, you can pray a duha until before zuhr by 5 minutes to 10, 5 to 10 minutes. So this is the time of duha, you can pray any time, inshallah. The Prophet ﷺ used to make it when the heat is like that before like 11 or 12 like this, when it's very heat.
Also in Sahih Bukhari,
Aisha
said that she never saw Prophet perform duha.
Yeah, this is the narration of Aisha radiallahu anhu. She never saw the Prophet ﷺ observe the rak'at al-duha, but other narrations in also Sahih al-Bukhari and other Muslim and other narrations said that the Prophet ﷺ did the duha or advised his companions to do the duha, and it is not necessary that Aisha radiallahu anha just comprehensively observe all of the acts of the Prophet ﷺ. She may miss one or two acts. Because we don't know the circumstances of their living. Maybe he never stayed with her in this time for maybe. So we never, or we don't know the circumstances. We understand that Aisha radiallahu anha may miss some of the acts of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in certain way or another, but we don't know how. We have other narrations in which other companions saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to pray the duha or even advised the companions to pray the duha. So in the Sharia, there is a kind of principle is man alima hujja ala man lam ya'lam. Those who know have the preference over those who don't know. So Aisha radiallahu anha didn't know that the Prophet ﷺ used to pray the duha. Other companions knew that the Prophet ﷺ prayed the duha. So we'll take a break, inshallah, for 10 minutes and then continue with the next hadith, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.